Hey, you guys, what's going on? So I'm in here to do the Q&A. Thank you to everyone who participated. Okay, what are you doing? Are you... Anyway, thank you to everyone who participated. So I'm going to get right into it. So Alicia Keys, it's not spelled the same way, but that's cute. I just realized that's what it was. Alicia Keys, you said, hey, who's your favorite male actor and female actor of all time? Why? And thanks in advance. And thanks for putting in the time and effort in creating your vlogs. You're welcome and thank you for watching. Now, my favorite male actor. Shit, I should have looked up the name. Oh, God. He's an action. Oh, he does a lot of action. I wouldn't say he's my favorite. I can't say I have a favorite male actor, but I enjoy watching his movies. Oh, my God. He's white. I'm going to put his picture up on the screen. I can't remember his name offhand, but I mean, I've seen all his movies. I just enjoy watching him. I mean, he doesn't say much. It's just a lot of fighting and, you know, yeah. Female actress. I can't say that I have a favorite female. Like, oh my God, I got to watch. I don't have one. My thing is, if a movie is good, if you're a good actor or actress, I'll watch it. But I can't say, you know, female-wise, the male one, like I said, and again, I like him because of, you know, the role he plays. It's like the same role in every damn movie. But, yeah, so thank you for your question. Sharon Arugle, yeah. So Sharon, you asked, are single people more productive or are people in a couple more productive? I think love can make some people crazy. I don't think so. I think whether you're single or you're in a relationship, you can be productive either way. And it's even great when two productive people get in a relationship. That's a power couple right there. Moves. But no, I don't think love makes people lazy. If you're lazy when you're single, you're lazy in a relationship. And it's kind of it's stressful if you're a lazy person, unproductive, unmotivated, and you get in a relationship with someone who is motivated and productive, and that person gotta like be pushing you to do something. No, stay by yourself and be lazy. Ah, bye y'all, bye. Texas Guy 39, you asked, have you ever visited Texas? If so, what part and what areas in the U.S. have you visited? Yes, I've been to Texas. When I was younger, when my brother was in the army, my family, you know, when he was on base, that's what you call it? Base, yeah. We visited him, and then I went in my late, maybe it's my mid-20s, yeah, my mid-20s, I was, yeah, so I believe in my life, I've only been to Texas two times, and no, I don't remember what part, because, again, I was young, and then the last time, I went to visit somebody, so it wasn't really, I just don't remember. What areas in the U.S. have you visited? A lot. Florida, Virginia, Atlanta, Texas. Canada's not. Canada. Oh shit! Don't laugh. I said Atlanta, Virginia. I've been to so many places. North. Whatchamacallit? North Carolina. Off the top of my head, that's what I remember. I've been a lot of places in my lifetime. But no, I've been a lot of places. Especially when I was younger, my parents traveled. They still travel. But like when I was younger, they took us everywhere. So I've been a lot of places. That's why right now, in my older age, I mean, I wonder why I go, but on the top of my list now, is, as I always gonna say, is I have to go to Japan or China. That's because I've been out of the U.S. as well. Yeah, but that was your question, so let's move along. Daycar 09, how you doing? Have you ever thought about making a channel for Strictly Cooking? I know you're gonna say too many channels to manage, but has a thought ever crossed your mind? Right now, I only have one channel. I started the Royals. I don't film for them anymore, so I'm only managing this channel, but I do other things outside of YouTube. And it's not a matter of having too many channels, it's just, I cook, but I don't cook like mad things to do a cooking channel. It wouldn't be consistent. And to me, if you're making a channel, if you're trying to do something, it has to be consistent. That's why I include those things in vlogs. Because again, I don't just cook to cook. You know, like, oh, let me go find a recipe and just make this. No, I'm cooking because I want to eat it. You know what I'm saying? So anytime that I do cook something, I will share it with y'all. And I can't do the step-by-step, oh, one half a teaspoon of salt. I can't do that because I don't cook from recipes. It's all through taste. I don't know how many times I'm going to say this. No, I will not do a cooking channel. I'm not mad at your question. It's just, no, understand. I don't know, but I've said it before. I will include when I cook in my vlogs. I'm not going to do separate. I've done little things, but the thing is, I cook the same things. You know, I don't, you know, so it just doesn't make sense. You understand? So what I will do anytime that I cook, I will include it in my vlogs. And when I say cook, it's doing something from scratch, because not everything I do from scratch. Shit, buy shit, warm it up in the oven. Yeah, and that's not really cooking because I ain't make it. Thank you for the question though. Moving along, Roshonda Duckett. How you doing? Isn't it crazy our vaping may be extinct in a few years? What made you get into vaping, or have you already done a video on that? No, I haven't done. I don't think I did a video on it. No, I don't believe I did. And yeah, it is, you know, crazy that it may not exist. And that's why I made sure I took part in everything that's going on with Congress and, you know, trying to not make that happen. Now, what made me get into vaping? It's a hobby for me. And some years ago, I started and I had a pen. That's what they call it, a pen. And I didn't understand, you know, I was interested then. I'm like, I got the pen and, you know, using it, then it started tasting funny. And I didn't know that you could change the filter. I threw that out and that was it for me. Because I'm like, shit, this didn't last too long. Threw it out. Then I got into the hookah pens. And I'm like, okay, they were fine, but again, you know, puffing on that for after a while, that thing goes quickly, and that was became a pretty expensive. It can become a costly thing. So years went by, and I don't know what it was, but I was hanging out with someone, and they vaping, and I smelled it. I'm like, what is that? And they told me what it was, and I was like, oh, that's what I used. You know, that's what I attempted to do before, but I had thrown away the pen because I didn't know you could change the filter. So I said, you know, so I started doing my research. This is something about me that, so the people, my friends, they know. When I'm interested in something, I do my research. That's how I got this little guy. I do my research, know what I want to do, plan, then attack. So then I found a store, looked around to find somewhere in Brooklyn where I can, you know, go and purchase a good equipment. Because I had to ask, you know, do my research, and I found a place, and that's where I go now, which is Next Gen Vape Shop in Brooklyn on Avenue U. Yes, I'm plugging them. So then I went and I bought my first, what I got first? I got the K-Box first, KangerTech. Then I got the Sub-Box. Now I'm into MechMods. What? Because when I'm into something, I'm into it. Like, it's like sneakers. I'm really into it, I invest in it. Cameras, I'm into it, I invest in it. Vaping, I'm into it, I invest in it. So that's how I got into it, and I love it. It's a hobby. This ties into a question, next question. Well, not the next question, but I'm gonna jump to this because it ties into this. King Vape, you asked, did you smoke before vaping, or did you just get into vaping? So that kind of answers your question. So it's no, I didn't smoke before. It's just a hobby. And again, why I made sure that I took part in the whole, if you want to call it, campaign so that it doesn't become a, because I feel for people who vaping has helped stop smoking. That's the, you know, for me, this is a hobby. It's like, you know, and I can't have to throw like, I don't care if vaping is gone. No, I feel for the people that this has made them stop smoking. It's changed their life health-wise and stuff. That's the, you know, that's shit like, fuck, you know, it's not cool. So, yeah, so that's to kill two birds with one stone. Moving on. Egg Alley Girl. Alley. That's Ally. A-L-Y. How you doing, girl? I really enjoy watching you and Sandy like this. I sat on the couch and he must be in my hand. I really enjoy watching you and Sandy. Love it when you give us a glimpse of your city. Glad you enjoy that. Please let us know your favorite TJ products. When I first, I was like, what the hell is TJ? I was like, oh, Trader Joe's. Got it. I didn't understand. I don't have a particular favorite product because me, how I shop, I go to Trader Joe's. Well, this month, I went twice in 1 month. I usually go once a month to Trader Joe's, and in between, I go to regular supermarket because I could get everything, you know, my necessity at Trader Joe's, and in between, if I need something, I'll go to the supermarket or the discount store. So everything that I showed in my last vlog at the end, those are products that I enjoy. I don't have a favorite. Like, okay, for example, you could, I don't know if I was, like, I love cookie butter, but it's not like, oh my God, I'm out of cookie butter, I gotta go to, I don't roll like that. Right now, I have a cookie butter. I don't know if you, again, you watch me. The last time you saw me buy cookie butter, I still have that same cookie butter. And it's good because I make sure I check the date. And if it's not good, I'm going to throw that shit out. But it's to 2016. Yes, because I don't eat it like that. It's very, I don't eat bread like that as well. It's, I eat bread mostly on the weekends. Maybe once in a week if I go to Subway and get a sandwich. So it's like, what am I putting cookie butter on? So it's just there. I don't particularly have a favorite. I love Trader Joe's, not only because they are inexpensive. And so when people say, oh, eating right, it costs too much money, lies and trash. Go to Trader Joe's, trust me. I went there, what I spent? I spent $120. If I went to a regular supermarket, I would have came home probably with two bags compared to all the shit that I came. So no, you can eat healthy. Stop the shit. Okay, moving right along. Last question, LBLB, how you say that, little pound pound, ha, that, is that what it is, pound pound, that's cute if that's what it is. What is your educational background and what industry do you work in? My educational background, what I went up to, I have my bachelor's, I graduated my bachelor's in English, yes, and I am in the arts field, that's all you're gonna get, yeah, so that's what I'm yeah, so that's it, yeah. I think I covered all your questions. Again, I appreciate everyone that participated. I enjoyed this. And if you want to be part of the next Q&A, leave your questions down below in addition to your comments. Yeah, I think I've touched, make sure I answered everyone's question asked. Yes. All right, people. I'm going back to watch some Law & Order and put this little puppy down. Say bye, everybody. Say I love you. Come, say hi. Don't be shady. Say hello to Say hello to the camera. Say hello. Say hi, everybody. Say hi. Did you just wink? You saw that? Ah, you winked. Ah.